Hi all, welcome back to Easy School Works. In this video, we are going to learn about properties of division of whole numbers. So, let's get started. We have five properties of division: closure property, commutative property, associative property, property of zero, identity property. First, we start with closure property. Closure property. Let us see with the examples. Take two whole numbers, 10 and 2. Divide 10 with 2. The quotient is 5 and 5 is a whole number. Now, take another two whole numbers, 6 and 3. Divide 6 with 3. The quotient is 2 and 2 is a whole number. Now, take another two whole numbers, 5 and 2. Divide 5 with 2. The quotient is 2.5 and it is not a whole number. Here, when we divide a whole number with another whole number, the quotient is not always a whole number. Let us say if A and B are any two whole numbers, then A divided by B is not always a whole number. Therefore, we can conclude that division is not closed for whole numbers. Now, commutative property. Let us see with the example. Take two whole numbers, 8 and 4, and divide 8 with 4. The answer is 2. Now, change the order. Means that divide 4 with 8. The answer is 1 by 2. See, here the answers are not same. Means that when we change the order and divide, we are not getting the same answers. Let us say if A and B are any two whole numbers, then A divided by B is not equal to B divided by A. Therefore, we can conclude that commutative property does not hold true for division of whole numbers. Now, associative property. Take three whole numbers, 8, 4 and 2. First, divide 8 with 4. And then divide with 2. 8 divided by 4 is 2. And then 2 divided by 2 is equal to 1. Now change the grouping and divide. First divide 4 with 2. 4 divided by 2 is 2. Now divide 8 with 2. 8 divided by 2 is equal to 4. See, here we are getting different answers. Means that when we change the grouping and divide, we are not getting the same answers. Let us say if A, B, C are any three whole numbers, then A divided by B divided by C is not equal to A divided by B divided by C. Therefore, we can conclude that associative property does not hold true for division of whole numbers. Now, property of zero. Let us see with the examples. Take the whole number 2 and divide 0 with 2. The quotient is 0. Now, take another whole number 5, divide 0 with 5. The quotient is 0. See, when we are dividing 0 with whole number, we are getting the quotient as 0. Let us say if A is any whole number other than 0, then 0 divided by A is equal to 0. Now, identity property. Let us see with the example. Take the whole number 5 and divide with 1. The quotient is that whole number itself. Now, take another whole number 3 and divide with 1. The quotient is that whole number itself. Means that when we divide a whole number with 1, we are getting the quotient as that whole number itself. Let us say if A is any whole number, then A divided by 1 is equal to A. So, 1 is called as division identity. Okay, I hope this video is very helpful to you. If you like my video, please like, share and subscribe. And don't forget to click on the bell icon. Thank you.